With me is EU's Trade Commissioner. So welcome to WION. My first question to you is an obvious question. Basically, coming from Jaipur, where the G20 trade ministers met, what were the conversations like? What is your assessment of India holding this key meeting?
Well, first of all, I would like to congratulate India on a very successful G20 presidency. So indeed, we had a very good G20 trade ministers meeting, but I'm hearing this also from other ministerial formations about the good organization of the meetings and indeed also reaching substantial agreements. So as regards our G20 trade ministerial meetings, there were a number of topics we covered, including ensuring the resilience of supply chains in a current more conflictual geopolitical context, discussing digital tools to facilitate trade, participation, how to improve participation of trade on small and medium-sized enterprises, and we are making progress across those areas.
Mm-hmm. So any update on the India-EU FTA? This is something that has been part of conversation, one of the key things when it comes to India-EU relationship as well.
Indeed, I'm using this visit also to have bilateral discussions, so including on progress we are making on free trade agreement, investment protection agreement. We are very intensively engaged. We had five negotiating rounds so far. And there is a willingness of both sides to continue with this good pace to achieve agreement as soon as possible. There is still, however, lots of ground to cover, also in terms of a scope of the agreement, because from the EU we are aiming for what we call deep and comprehensive free trade agreement, which covers not only traditional, tariff questions, but also other questions, including on sustainable development, to avoid a situation where trade is causing harm for environment or leads to lower labor standards. So we'll need to discuss how to properly address all those topics.
Mm-hmm. Any deadline when it comes to FTA? I know when it comes to FTA talks, these aren't easy conversations. We have had an experience of past as well. So any deadline you're looking at?
Well, as we are saying in the EU, it's substance over deadlines. So we are willing to engage intensively and continue to work at a good pace. But at the end of the day, we need to get substance right to be able to conclude.
Mm-hmm. So India has been calling for reforms of the World Trade Organization. What is your take on the reforms of this body?
Well, indeed, that's very much also the EU's view. This was also one of the topics we discussed at G20, and I think G20 can be important player in this regard on preparation of a WTO ministerial meeting. And it is something which has been agreed also among broader WTO membership in the last ministerial conference, that we need to work on this WTO reform. We need to bring WTO in the 21st century with ways to address climate change, with ways to function in a digital economy, and also to address new challenges, a number of them stemming from socio-economic model of China, like questions on industrial subsidies and transparency of industrial subsidies, role of state and state-owned enterprises and their competitive neutrality, intellectual property rights. When we discuss WTO, another important element for WTO reform is restoration of the functioning of the dispute settlement system, which we, as we know, currently is not working because appellate body is blocked.
Mm-hmm. Movement of people from India to EU, especially skilled migration, what kind of conversation has been happening? Are you looking at a mobility pact with India? The several EU countries have signed, eager to sign, for example, Italy. But if you can talk about that, especially any talks of mobility pact.
Yeah, it must be said, this is not the area which I'm covering in the European Commission. As regards our free trade agreement negotiations, they are covering only some specific aspects of the mobility, like mobility of professionals linked with the provision of services. So these discussions we are obviously going to have in the context of our negotiations.
Mm-hmm. So the import of refined oil products from India to European Union. What sort of policy you have? Because there have been comments coming from EU over that, especially the refined products which are made from Russian crude oil.
It's a new phenomenon, and indeed we are currently assessing it, and I would say it's a cause of concern, mm-hmm. because we have introduced sanctions against Russia, and the largest revenue source for Russian budget is oil and oil products export. So with the EU's oil embargo, with G7 plus price cap, we aim to reduce Russia's oil revenue. Mm-hmm. We know that Russia is actively seeking new markets, but now when we see the situation when many refined products are arriving in the EU market which are made from Russian oil, that actually defeats the purpose of why those sanctions were put in place originally. So we are currently assessing what can be the policy response to this.
And have you raised the matter with the Indian side ever? Do you plan to raise? Is it part of conversation? Not in the context of your conversations, which perhaps are happening today, but otherwise as well?
Indeed, obviously, we're raising it with our Indian counterparts. And I would say also broader, the broader question of avoidance of sanctions and convention by Russia is something we are in discussions with quite a number of countries.
Have you raised it, sir, with your counterpart?
I had been raising this. It's not part of our FTA negotiations, but it's something we are obviously flagging that it's a topic we are currently assessing.
Mm-hmm. So my last question to you, you're going to hold conversation with your counterpart on trade and investment, the dialogue on trade and investment later today. So what will be the key focus areas which you are going to talk about?
There are a number of areas which we need to cover. Obviously, we'll take stock on progress of our FTA negotiations, but we are also discussing state of play of our existing trade and investment relations, trade irritants, what can be done to remove them, what can be done to facilitate trade, also in a current context before we have an FTA.
Mm-hmm. And what irritants, if you can just elaborate on that, an additional question to my last question.
I think there are a number of topics which are well known from both sides, which we need to discuss. Maybe I'll not now go into detail, as I'll be raising it directly with my counterparts. I would say, that's a fact. When you have intensive trade relations between countries, regions, there are inevitably some issues which are emerging. So what is important is not that there are issues, but that there is a willingness to resolve those issues from the both sides, mm-hmm. and that there are dialogue to do so.
Mm-hmm. Well, thank you so much, sir, for speaking to WION. It was a pleasure speaking to you, sir. Thank you so much, sir. With video journalist Jinu Sidhant Sibal for WION in New Delhi.